in and we're all working together and you watch this thing slowly but magically come alive.
I leapt at the idea, writing for Disney characters, writing funny songs, sad songs, love songs that have nothing to do with my life.
All along the mountain tree, if you're walking like a llama, then you just can't feel.
This whole song is about llamas in Incan society and the position, you know. The premise is that the entire civilization is dependent on the llama, because you can't have a civilization if you don't have any clothes on.
I decided to collaborate because I didn't want them to be Sting songs. I didn't want necessarily to sound like Sting. And I chose Dave Hartley because I'd worked with him a few times, a wonderful piano player, very funny. I have a great deal of love and affection for each other.
I don't know what they're going to do with that.
You want some too? You've been really helpful.
Now the llama walks so proud, the llama holds his head in the cloud. All along the mountain trail, you wander like a llama, then you just can't feel.
Songs are sometimes you just find them, and then some songs you really have to sort of dig. It's a love song, boy and a girl. The boy is an imposter. He's pretending to be the emperor, and he's not. And he's troubled by that, because he's fallen in love with this girl, but as an imposter.
I'd never imagined before that the world could be turned on his head. I'd never have thought to be here in this place.
How can she love me if she really finds out that I'm just a shepherd? And she is puzzled because she knew him before, or she knew the emperor that he's impersonating, and he seems different.
He walks in the room and I'm never quite sure if he's trying to be somebody else. I'm liking him better, that he's not his arrogant self.
So she's confused, and getting them both to meet in that confusion was the problem. But one day they both imagine that they will love each other, which in fact they do.
Always the clouds coming in, obscuring, clouds revealing, you know? So the final chorus, we can go even further with this kind of metaphor and take them somewhere else.
Oh,
and the men who adored you no longer soon. It pays to avoid the sunlit days and live by the night.
I love this loungy quality because it's so earthy.
But the moon grows old just like us all, and her beautiful years are done. So now she prays through endless days to take her revenge on the sun.
The rest of the story was still in a sort of a molding, shaping stages. The song kind of found itself very early on, very quickly.
When I was a girl at my daddy's side, Papa, the royal mortician, revealed to me in secret signs the mark of the magician. And daddy was no dummy, did outrageous things with the mummy, and often the stiffs that he would drive would look better dead than they did alive. Soupy baby turned me on, every wrinkle soon be gone. I could squeeze myself with glee, the promises you made to me. I've really stopped at nothing, murder, treachery, and lying. Whatever it takes to keep my looks, you really can't blame a girl for trying. Snuff out the light, claim your right to a world of darkness. Snuff out the light, here tonight.
Just having a blast working with dead things.
In those common things, transurrhythm, apparition, spirit, demon, phantom, shame, salamander, serpent, darkness, devil, dance, and watch the dice.
But now that it's all up in the air with, you know, plot and story and characterization and structure, then it looks like we're here for a while yet. But I feel galvanized, actually, though. To put more into it, to be more creative, you know.
I've got a cue on another mirror.
Somebody was talking about this little character, the Huaca, you know, and they were saying, well, what's he about? Someone said, oh, who it was? Someone said, oh, it's like, why can't the human be more like a rock? Which reminded me of a song from My Fair Lady called Why Can't the Woman Be More Like a Man, which is sung by Rex Harrison. So I thought, wait a minute.
Why can't a human be more like a rock? Dependable, unshakable, and stoic. A cornerstone of empire, stability, and trust. Ever patient, ever vigilant, and essentially heroic. Ever humans always chasing after figment and illusion. Always anxious, always searching, but a victim of illusion. Ever finds his happiness, he'll probably die of shock. Oh, why can't a human be more like a rock?